a lot of rain. Now, I want to show you something about this front. This is a classic scenario for severe weather. You know why? We have warm air out ahead of it and a lot of moisture moving in out of the Gulf of Mexico and cooler, drier air behind it. How do we know that? Well, typically we take a look at the dew point, the measurement of moisture in the atmosphere or in the air. Look how dry things are back here. If you see dew points in the teens and 20s, you know it's very dry. If you see them in the 50s and the 60s, which commonly you do in the southeast, you know it's very muggy, it's very humid, and yeah, you got a lot of soup here. You got a lot of moisture, in other words. So conditions are favorable for severe weather in these locales. And that's why we have the darker red shading on this particular map. Now, as I put this into motion, I do want to point out that we still have a tornado warning in effect for Jefferson County right here. See that nasty storm bearing down on Birmingham? You need to seek shelter immediately. Doppler radar has indicated the possibility of a tornado there. Now, looking at the coast of southeastern Texas, we have seen our fair share of nasty weather here today in the form of hail, gusty winds, even some flooding around Victoria County, Texas, flash flood warning in effect, and follow those showers and thunder showers right on to the south of Shreveport into Jackson, Madison County. Big time thunderstorms about to rock through Birmingham again, so you're going to get another round of it after dealing with that storm that's right on top of you. And you know what? Big time thunderstorms also to the south of the Atlanta metro area. If you're taking I-75, or even I-20 out of Atlanta, it looks pretty nasty. And Nashville is getting hammered even as we speak, and big time thunderstorms to the north and east of Nashville. Looks like it's going to be one of those nights in Knoxville and Bristol and even southeastern sections of Kentucky. Northern Kentucky getting into the lighter rainfall right now, so that is excellent news for folks in Louisville and Cincinnati and even into Columbus. So that's a look at the severe weather. Jeff is going to take a look at the nicer weather.
Yeah, we're going to head out west, Jeanetta, but not till we take a stop into an area that had to deal with a lot of slush and a lot of snow. Yeah, we had some snow again in the Twin Cities. It's been that kind of winter and is kind of held over into the springtime now. Folks out there shoveling out the slushy snow, but the sun is so strong, even through the cloudy skies today, it really kind of loosened all that snow up. Yeah, it was a kind of a day you had to get the old squeegee out there and kind of clean off the windshield to get all that slushy spray. The good news here is the temperatures are going to be warming up rather nicely over the next couple of days, so it looks like a lot of that snow is going to be out of there. Unfortunately, that's going to create quite a quagmire, I would say, anywhere where it snowed up here in Minnesota. That snow, what's left of it, has now moved on over into Upper Michigan. Temperatures there cold enough to support some snow sticking on some untreated road services, but I wouldn't expect any major travel problems. The snow's just not coming down that hard. Minneapolis now down to the freezing mark. We might have to worry about a little bit of refreezing of slush and some of that snow on some untreated roads, but overall, it's just kind of a messy time of it there in the Twin Cities. There's what's left of our snow now moving through Alpena and Traverse City and right down I-75, maybe down toward Flint Saginaw eventually, but again, don't expect any travel problems out of that snow. It is rain, the back edge of it about to Detroit now, down to Cleveland. It's raining in Pittsburgh, and it is raining all the way up to Syracuse, Watertown, and on over toward the Albany area at 41 degrees. Head up to Burlington. There's still some wet snow. You can be sure that in the mountains here, from the northern Adirondacks through the Green and Whites, there are still some heavier snows coming down, but it's a wet snow. Don't know that it'll be great for skiing, but there'll be a few additional inches accumulating. Lower elevations are going to be changing over to rain in most cases. It is warm enough for all rain right now in Boston, although all the precipitation is generally to your north. But take heart, all this rain out to the west is headed toward Boston, Providence, New York, Philly, and D.C. as we head through the overnight hours and early morning hours on your Wednesday. The west, by contrast, is quiet. Really no precipitation except for a few showers up around the Puget Sound from Seattle up to Bellingham and out to the Olympic Peninsula, and some light rain showers toward El Paso. Other than that, things are really quiet. The clouds and rain keeping temperatures down to about 45 in El Paso. By contrast, 74 at the Sky Harbor Airport in Phoenix, along the Strip at Vegas, 72, 68 at San Diego, and still a very pleasant 79, kind of balmy there at LA. 58's now cooled below the 60-degree mark in Seattle, but still not bad. A few sprinkles will be moving into the area, and 69 in Portland. Don't see any cold air on the horizon here, that's for sure. In fact, we don't see much in the way of storminess in the western part of the country, probably right on through the upcoming weekend. But we will talk more about that in the forecast, and that's coming up, right, Jeanetta?
Yeah, and we've even got a special Easter sunrise service forecast for everyone.
That's coming up too.
Well, still ahead on this edition of WeatherScope, in addition to the detailed forecast for the nation, we'll also look into the Easter weekend for all you spring breakers.
That's right. And what a show in the skies over Oklahoma. We have an unusual weather occurrence to tell you about coming up on the second half of WeatherScope.
Now there's a hearing aid for Miracle Ear so advanced it's virtually invisible. Now you see it? Now you don't. It's the Mirage hearing aid for Miracle Ear. Call now. We'll send you these three booklets that tell you how the virtually invisible Mirage may help you hear better. If you call 1-800-582-4664 right now, we'll also send you this free videotape, Hearing Loss in You. It'll show you the most common causes and solutions for hearing loss. And we'll include the free booklets about the Mirage hearing aid from Miracle Ear. You see, Mirage is our most advanced hearing aid that fits completely into the ear canal. It's not only small, it's virtually invisible. Call Miracle Ear at 1-800-582-4664. We'll send you important new information about hearing loss and the virtually invisible Mirage.
It's amazing. I know he's wearing it, but I can't see it.
So call Miracle Ear at 1-800-582-4664. Call now.
Know what to expect. Watch our 5-day planner 20 minutes after every hour on the Weather Channel. No place on Earth has better weather. WeatherScope continues right after this local forecast on the Weather Channel.
Welcome back to this edition of WeatherScope. I'm Jeff Morrow.
And I'm Jeanetta Jones.
Right now, a storm system is making its way slowly across the eastern part of the United States, stretching all the way from Texas to New England.
Last night, that same storm system created an amazing sight in the skies over Oklahoma City. Thunderstorms lit up the sky, triggering a spectacular sight. A lightning show started from the ground and reached into the skies. This type of flash occurs when the ground has a negative charge and the clouds a positive charge. It's the reverse of a normal lightning storm. How about that? Ground-to-cloud lightning most often occurs during thunderstorms in the winter months, when positively charged ice crystals are closer to the ground. Here's a look at other ways lightning can strike.
Lightning is very dangerous and frightening, but lightning is simply electricity in the air. This electricity can occur within a cloud, from one cloud to another, or between a cloud and the ground. The amount of energy released by a lightning storm is amazing. The total amount of energy in a major thunderstorm is greater than an atomic bomb. Cloud-to-ground lightning is the simplest type of lightning to study. That's because the light produced by the elements of the flash can be photographed and examined to determine physical properties of the flash. such as speed, temperature, and pressure. At any given moment, there are at least 1,800 storms producing 100 bolts of lightning throughout the world. On any given day, there are some 44,000 thunderstorms, producing over 8 million lightning flashes.
Again, we have some of that severe weather to talk about over much of the southeast tonight. And looks like this front's going to
be colder than where you stood this time last night. So that front did make a difference, pulling down some cooler air. Currently 49 in Atlanta, 39 up around Pittsburgh, 38 up around Boston, and 52. It's actually warmer in Chicago than what we have in Atlanta right now. Some of the coldest air has been concentrated across the northeast. And that's where it's going to stay, we think, and we'll talk more about that in the forecast. But 38 around Boston, as I mentioned earlier, 34 up around Burlington, and again, some of these areas seeing some light snow showers, nothing big coming down, and nothing that should cause you too many problems, but just a few areas with some snow showers here and there. Into the southeast we go. I told you about the ridge of high pressure that's building on in. Again, our showers, our thunderstorms have pretty well subsided. I wanted to show this so you could see how everything's kind of moving on off to sea, and we're looking at a drier forecast overnight. Come tomorrow, especially heading into southern and western portions of the peninsula here, we may see a few more thunderstorms popping up. We'll have to keep an eye out for that. Other than that, though, fairly quiet for much of the east. Different story out west. We have a couple of systems to speak of out there. Mike?
There, and with that Thursday forecast, here is Sharon Resultan.
All righty, let's check it out as we head on into Thursday morning. Did you drop something there, Mike? We're going to check out your Thursday morning where it's pretty quiet across most of the nation. Of course, we're going to be watching in the Pacific Northwest. Mike already alluded to high pressure moving in, but briefly, and then the next system will be pulling on in for the afternoon. Heading into Texas, again, what earlier thought that we might find some stronger thunderstorms here. That was a concern. Latest computer models showing that there might be just a little bit too much warm air in the mid-levels of the atmosphere to kind of cap any big thunderstorms from forming. So we'll watch that closely as we head through the day on Thursday on into the afternoon hours. Looks like you'll also see some significant moisture moving on into Louisiana. So could see some rain around the Big Easy and around Shreveport as well. Few stray showers also into parts of South Florida and up to the north, this area of low pressure producing a little bit of rain, and on the very, very northern and westernmost reaches where it runs into some colder air, you could find a little bit of some snowfall there as well. Again, a look at your precipitation forecast. Much of this is for what's going to be happening tomorrow, the exception being what's going on right now in the Pacific Northwest. And we do have some advisories out. We've had some pretty good snow coming down around Stampede Pass, so we'll continue to watch around that level. Of course, the snow levels have fallen considerably since that front has moved onshore and pushed off to the east, ushering some cooler air in behind it. Again, some nice warmth spreading northward up towards Chicago, moving up toward Detroit. The question is this going to stick around this far north for Good Friday and on into Easter Sunday? Let's check it out with Mike.
Okay, Sharon, here we go. Here's Good Friday and still plenty of warm air, lots of bright colors on the map, so that means temperatures above 60 degrees for a lot of us. However, there will be a series of weather fronts moving from west to east between now and Monday, and each front will bring a round of showers and storms. It will be a quick-moving system. Both of those systems will be quick-moving, so we're not going to have any prolonged rainfall, but look for some more rain. And with a second front, here comes the cool air, and by Monday, look at the highs in the northeast, only in the 30s and 40s, so some pretty nippy weather as we round out the month of March. Still nice in Florida, and the deserts begin to heat back up above 90 degrees. Here's our first front on Good Friday, showers and storms invading the mid-Atlantic, D.C. and Baltimore, raining Friday night and Saturday in New England and the Northeast. Boston all the way down to Philadelphia, count on some wet weather Saturday, about a 50-50 Easter weekend now. Then as we get into Sunday, there's your forecast. Now, Easter Sunday sunrise services will be kind of nippy in the Northeast, mid-Atlantic, but most of us won't have half-bad weather, but carry the umbrella around Chicago and Houston, and then that system on Monday, that weather front moves to the East Coast, I should say from Sunday into Monday, but by then we'll be back in, most of us will be back into the work and school routine.
Mm-hmm. Did you see that on Monday? Could see some rain into San Francisco as well.
Okay. Your local forecast coming up in a moment.
Wherever business takes you, call Thrifty Car Rental first at 1-800-4-CARS. Thrifty offers low rates on first-rate transportation. Call us toll-free 24 hours coast-to-coast and get great deals on the best wheels. Now for only $29.95 a day, rent a Dodge Stratus or similar mid-size car from Thrifty. Just $29.95 a day.
Best of all is Thrifty.
American movie class. Classics brings everyone who loves a hero closer to the legends of classic Hollywood. Find them all on AMC. American Movie Classics, the original classic movie network.
This weekend, Richard Burton stars in The Robe.
This is your local forecast, weather information you can plan on, because we show it on the 8s of every hour. Local on the 8s on the Weather Channel.
WeatherScope. Well, we still have some reports of severe weather, some severe thunderstorms across the southern plains at this hour. Good evening, I'm Jeff Morrow.
And I'm Sharon Resultan. We'll also have all that all-important Easter weekend forecast, but first, another peek at some of the severe thunderstorms and what's causing the active weather. And we'll take you first into the current map, and you'll be able to see lots and lots of green on the map there. Showers and thunderstorms blossom during the late afternoon hours and on into the early evening, and that's where we continue to see the problems into eastern Kansas, extreme northeastern Oklahoma, although our particular supercell we've been watching is now crossing over into extreme southwestern Missouri and northwestern Arkansas, so some warnings have been established across that region. So this has been the problem zone, and there are a few reasons why. With the southerly winds ahead of this whole system, we continue to draw in some moisture, and you can see the dew points have been on the rise here into the lower 60s around Dallas, lower 50s into Oklahoma City. Not quite as much moisture to work with up into Oklahoma and Kansas, but we've had another mechanism helping along these thunderstorms, and that has been our rather strong upper level system that's been moving on through. You can see it on the water vapor loop here. You can see the twisting motion of the clouds, and it's actually passing through southern Kansas, northern Oklahoma, and stretching now into Missouri and Arkansas. So you get moisture that's, you get an atmosphere that's moist enough, and some sort of a mechanism here with a lot of dynamics, a lot of energy, and you get some of those thunderstorms. And we continue to see the potential for severe weather. So we're watching this particular watch area. This has been issued as of the top of the hour and is in effect until 3 a.m. local time, covering a good chunk of southwestern Missouri as all these storms have been moving to the east and northeast. Our supercell, it's really, really weakening now. That's good news. But we still are watching for some severe weather, maybe some gusty winds out of that. So heading into northern Benton County in Arkansas and also McDonald County here in southwestern Missouri, this region, we do still have severe thunderstorm warnings in effect. Still watching also around the Wichita area into Butler County, a severe thunderstorm warning in effect there. And a few more thunderstorms here from Liberal Kansas on into the panhandle of Oklahoma, and more thunderstorms also, mainly more of a rain event though, heading into south central and southeastern portions of Missouri. A lot of active weather out there, and we head northward. We'll find Topeka on the southern fringes of some of that moisture, the moisture stretching northward up toward Dubuque and up around Chicago as well. So a real wet go of it ahead of this cold front, where we continue to see the southerly flow of air. And those showers will slowly be spreading on eastward with this system as we work our way on into the daytime hours for your Friday. Backside of this, we're pulling down some cooler Canadian air, so a little snow coming down into the western Dakotas. Still some rain, though, into the Black Hills of South Dakota. And further off to the west, what's this but more rain in the Pacific Northwest? Yep, another system is getting close to moving onshore here, and that's ushering in more moisture. So up and down Interstate 5 from Seattle to Portland down into Salem, you're running into more rain. Slow it down. Make sure you don't hydroplane. Play it safe here as the rain will continue through tonight. That's a look at the moisture. How about temperatures? We'll check that out with Jeff.
Well, we did have some nice weather out there, Sharon. As a matter of fact, we had some gorgeous weather in places like Chicago and St. Louis and well into the southeast. Here's Chicago, living up to its nickname, the Windy City, but these were warm winds blowing in some readings well up into the 70s. Check it out, folks out there in shorts doing some inline skating and having a good time out by the lakefront there. As long as that wind's not blowing off the lake, you're okay. Kind of jogging to beat the grader there, I guess. Meanwhile, in Forest Park, Missouri, this is near St. Louis, the scenes were much the same. Folks out by the lake feeding the ducks in shirt sleeves. But don't get too used to it, folks, because it looks like some cooler air is on the way, particularly for the Chicagoland area over the next couple of days. There's some happy-looking inline skaters. Better use the sunscreen, though. You know, the sun's pretty high in the sky. That guy didn't have a shirt on there, and he's going to get burned if he's not careful. Let's go ahead and take a look at your current weather map. High pressure dominates the southwest. High pressure is dominating the east, and for most of both of those regions, and as we just showed you around Chicago and St. Louis, it was a pretty nice day. Rain moving into both of those areas now, but earlier, look at that, 20 to 25 degrees above average for this time of the year. I mean, we're almost into April now, so you have to expect that things are going to warm up, but we're almost jumping almost into early summertime readings in some cases. Look at that, 75 in Chicago, 71 in the Motor City in Detroit. My hometown of Pittsburgh got up to 70. It must have been a gorgeous day to head down to Point State Park. 69, nice day to head out in Brown Bagot at Central Park today. Nice day to head to Piedmont Park. We're making the park rounds here down to Atlanta. And if you're headed down to Key Biscayne, 86 was the high in Miami. It's currently 76 there, a beautiful Miami evening. 57 in Nashville, 62 in St. Louis, 58 in Kansas City. We do have a little bit of cooler air lurking here to the north. The question is that going to be headed south? And do we have any more severe weather to worry about as we head on through Good Friday? With more on both of those stories, here's Sharon.
Let's check it out as we head into your Friday morning. Okay, there it is. And we'll show you here as we work our way into Good Friday morning that we are going to have some pesky showers to contend with. Again, watch out in this region for maybe the potential for some strong, maybe some severe weather popping up again, more so into the afternoon hour. That will be something. The southerly winds will continue to draw the moisture on northward. So here we go. From the deep south on up into the Ohio River Valley and southern Great Lakes, all these areas will be fair game for some widely scattered showers and pop-up thunderstorms. Around this area of low pressure, we wrap in some cooler air. So into the Arrowhead of Minnesota, there's enough cold air in place. You'll see a few snow showers while things will begin to dry up in the Pacific Northwest. Looks like the Northeast will be okay. Maybe by the afternoon, some showers spreading in with the warm front there around the Finger Lakes region, on into the Susquehanna region of New York. But New York City, Hartford, and Boston looking dry for your Good Friday. A look at your precipitation forecast, and as we look at the snowfall, again into the higher elevations of the Washington Cascades, could find maybe over 6 inches in some of the very highest elevations. Lighter amounts with that system winding the cooler air back in out of Canada, so northern North Dakota on into northern Minnesota, maybe a couple of inches there, and not expecting anything like that into the north and east. But we will have some pretty chilly air to contend with across northern New England for your Friday morning. Good Friday, looking at highs around the Ohio River Valley in the 70s. Look at the 80s here along the Gulf Coast. Perfect for spring breakers heading down into Florida. Even a band of some 90s into South Texas. Parts of the desert southwest warming up as well. Question, is it going to remain this nice heading into your Easter weekend? Cross your fingers. We can only hope. Jeff will tell you.
Oh, yeah. Put the onus on me. Fine. I'm going to be the bearer of bad news. Not everywhere, though. Actually, you know, Sharon's a big golfer and a big golf fan, and I think the weather's going to be absolutely great for golf across much of the deep south. There will be some showers to be dodged from time to time, particularly on Good Friday. Might be a few isolated big thunderstorms, but other than that, the weather's going to be gorgeous for your Easter holiday. But to the north, well, let's see. We were talking about Pittsburgh being up into the 60s today, probably 70s Good Friday, back down into the 50s. Cleveland, pretty much the same deal. Detroit, your run of nice weather is over too. It can happen that way this time of the year. Warm air gets pulled ahead of one system, then the next front comes by and it chills it right back down. You're on a bit of a roller coaster ride here. So again, don't put the jackets and the sweaters away yet. You're going to need them around Detroit. And as we head on over to, around the Chicagoland area, highs only in the 40s. On into Monday, some of that chilly air moves right on over through upstate New York, into Boston, and probably right on down through New York and Philadelphia. One of the reasons it's going to cool down is because we're going to have rain here. So should you wear your Easter bonnet or should you have the umbrella to protect it? I think you better have your umbrella for sure. At Boston, maybe back to Worcester, and some snow showers flying. Oh, better have the heavy overcoat over that Easter outfit in places like Buffalo and Rochester and Erie, Pennsylvania. Still lingering snow showers there and a brisk wind, too, as we round out the month of March, not going out like a lamb in New England.
Came in like a lion,
yes.
Going out like a lion.
At least in New England, anyway.
Yeah, it seems to be. We're going to check on the weather in Europe when we return. We'll see how things are faring there in case you're going to spend the holiday overseas. Stick around.
How's my precious?
As you do, Osmocote. Just one sprinkle of Osmocote's time-release granules feeds your plants continuously, every second of every day, all season long, indoors and out.
Look, he's got his father's leaves.
Osmocote, the plant food for plant lovers.
This is your local forecast, weather information you can plan on, because we show it on the 8s of every hour. Local on the 8s on the Weather Channel.
As fathers dance with daughters. As long as there are welcome mats and childhood sweethearts. Just as long as families come together, Maxwell House will always be good to the last drop.
Let's go ahead and take a look at international weather, and we start you off with a midday map for Friday. And as Sharon was just joking to me a second ago, you better have tickets on the Concorde if you're going to get over there this fast and leave like right now to get over there. What we'll see as we head on through the weekend is this high drifting over most of Europe, and actually it looks to be fairly pleasant. And I imagine some folks may be headed over to Rome in the Vatican for the Easter services, either maybe even Good Friday. Of course, if you're going to make it for Good Friday, you should be there already. But for Easter Sunday, it looks like this front will sweep on by to the south, and some of these 50s will be shifting a little bit farther east into Central Europe as well. These are some Saturday actual city forecasts. A few showers expected in Athens. London should be mostly cloudy, low 50s expected there. There's Rome for Saturday, partly cloudy, upper 50s. And again, it should stay nice right there into Easter Sunday. Frankfurt, some clouds, mostly cloudy in Vienna, and Paris, partly sunny, and a high near 50 degrees, so a little bit on the cool side there in the City of Light. All right, coming up, we're going to take a look at a few travel trouble areas. We have some snow to show you, and still the risk for severe weather tonight. Stay tuned, we'll show you where.
Ooh, these feel good. Lauren, come on, let me see.
If you've been working for a favorite look.
Those are great.
Yeah? Mm-hmm. Part of getting that look should be including Kellogg's Special K. Great toasted taste, 110 calories, and fat-free.
Buy them. Buy
Kellogg's Special K. Great taste never looks so good.
Yeah.
Up here, I feel like traffic is miles away.
With the most horsepower in its class and its accommodating size.
Unlike some others, I have virtually unlimited capacity.
Yukon can make you feel invincible. Yukon by GMC. It puts you comfortably in command.
Time to take a look at some traveling conditions back in the States, and still a threat for severe weather where you see the red shading here from southwest Missouri, much of Arkansas, including the Little Rock area maybe later on. And still the threat of some thunderstorms in northeast Oklahoma and southeast parts of Kansas. That's where the Storm Prediction Center has this severe thunderstorm watch out until 3 a.m. Central Standard Time. Does include Joplin and Springfield in Missouri, just to name two of the towns that may be affected pretty soon here. See this one particular cell that moved from just south of Tulsa over to northwest Arkansas, about to move up into Missouri. That's a supercell. That's out by itself, and it has a history of up to 1.75 inches hail and some very gusty winds. And we've had some very gusty winds up to the north here. Looks like a new batch of storms developing just east of Wichita, so we'll have to watch very closely there. For again, gusty winds, heavy downpours, and hail could be doing some damage there. You might find some wet roadways isolated all through the Ohio Valley and back into the central Mississippi Valley and the Pacific Northwest through the noon hour Friday. Snow confined mainly to the higher elevations of Washington, Oregon, and Idaho. Coming up, Sharon takes a look at tonight's severe weather and where it could be headed.
If you're busy, and who isn't these days, you don't have time to fool with brake repairs. So at Midas, we give your brakes a thorough inspection and explain your options. It's the Midas way, a better system for you and your car.
Hate the taste of Arm & Hammer toothpaste? Then try new Smooth Spearmint. Now the baking soda toothpaste that dentists recommend most has a refreshing spearmint ribbon of flavor. New Smooth Spearmint from Arm & Hammer.
It is a little strong for the nose.
Would I use bleach more if it smelled better? Yes, I would.
Introducing Fresh Scent Clorox Cleanup.
You cannot believe that there's bleach in here.
It's just a fresh, clean smell.
It does smell very good.
Try new Fresh Scent Clorox Cleanup.
Right now, the weather is changing. What's here today can be gone tomorrow. Because we know you need to plan and prepare, we dedicate a special team to forecasting the outlook for the days ahead. So you know what to expect. Watch our 5-day planner, 20 minutes after every hour on the Weather Channel. No place on Earth has better weather. Get detailed ski conditions for over 200 resorts on the Weather Channel website, www.weather.com. No place on Earth has better weather.
Introducing the first ever daily protein remover for soft contact lenses, OptiFree Super Cleanse. It keeps your lenses like new longer. Call and try it. Free.
Hello? A free sample? No. Free is good if the product is great. So what would be great is some cold hard facts, right?
Fact. People who use Super Cleanse every day for 6 months said their soft contact lenses felt as comfortable as a pair less than a week old.
Contacts I start wearing in winter can feel as comfortable as new. Come summer, it's got to be hard work, right?
Super Cleanse is easy. Just one drop in your lens case overnight with OptiFree Express Multipurpose Solution. It's unbelievably simple.
Just one drop while I sleep. I'm dreaming. Now, this free sample, please tell me it's not a one-time shot. Please tell me it cries out, try me again and again for a whole month.
Okay. We'll give you a 30-day supply free.
Sold.
Call now for your one-month supply of OptiFree Super Cleanse or buy some wherever lens care products are sold. Try it. Feel it. Believe it.
This is your local forecast. Weather information you can plan on because we show it on the 8s of every hour. Local on the 8s on the Weather Channel.
We'll be right back.
The Weather Channel. No place on earth has better weather.
All righty, let's take a look at some spring weather out there, and there is a lot to talk about in that category. You think of spring and you think of thunderstorms, and we've had more than our fair share of that this evening. Could see some more of that winding up again tomorrow afternoon and evening, so you want to pay close attention. Heading through tonight, this is where we think we might still find the strong to severe thunderstorms, again stretching from eastern Kansas and Oklahoma all the way on out into most of Missouri and Arkansas, and maybe even some gusty winds extending along the Ohio River Valley towards, say, Evansville and up toward Covington as we work our way through the nighttime hours. We do have, one watch area in effect here now. The old one has expired. This has been established in its place, and it's been displaced a little bit further eastward because the storms are moving across this particular region. So until 3 o'clock local time, you folks in southwestern Missouri, eastern Kansas, extreme northern Arkansas need to be aware that the potential is there for some strong to severe thunderstorms. Let's take a look at it in a closer inspection here. Our supercell has weakened considerably, I'm glad to say, but still watching. Now, we had earlier in Benton County and also into McDonald County, severe thunderstorm warnings in effect, and those have expired. And as we work our way just east of Wichita, still some problems around Butler County, severe thunderstorm warning in effect there for the next 5 minutes or so. Wouldn't be surprised to see maybe a few more warnings issued possibly here as those storms seem to be holding on to their intensity. A lot of heavy rain with this. Earlier we had reports of hail heading into just east of the Tulsa area, hail about an inch and a half in diameter. Just damaging hail, wind 60 to 70 mile per hour with that particular supercell. And now all this is working its way towards Springfield. Still some gusty winds with that cell, but it has, as I mentioned earlier, weakened considerably. A lot of moisture also stretching on up into Missouri, and there's another inspection of it up around Topeka, southern fringe of it there. Missing it right now around Kansas City. This is all moving to the east and northeast at about 35 miles per hour. And the moisture itself working on into northern portions of Illinois, so maybe even on into Chicago, looking at some wet weather overnight. There again is the extent of the lightning data. You can see these are all the cloud-to-ground lightning strikes, the white ones being the very latest ones that have occurred, say, in the past 10 to 15 minutes or so. So still a very active scenario out here. And even into southeastern Missouri, we're looking at quite a few thunderstorms in progress. Here's a look at your current map once again. It's quiet up and down the eastern seaboard. Again, there's the moisture stretching into Chicago, maybe even into the Kenosha area of Wisconsin. Backside of this area of low pressure, it's drawing down some cooler Canadian air. So we're running into a little bit of light snow here and a brand new system moving into the Pacific Northwest, promising some more rain across western portions of Washington and Oregon. A quick peek at temperatures, nothing too extreme here on the map. Looking at some 50s along the Ohio River Valley and some 60s as you can see along the Gulf Coast, some more balmy 70s heading into central and southern portions of the Sunshine State. Again, there's a look at the dew points. Very, very humid atmosphere heading down into Florida. We've been watching the southerly winds drawing in some more of that moisture closer to the surface, so the dew points have been on the rise here. But it's that in combination with our upper level system that's been scooting through this region, and that's really created some of the uplift to get some of those stronger thunderstorms going. And we continue to see that from the water vapor loop. You can also see some of the lines of showers and thunderstorms now stretching through parts of Missouri. Again, there's a look at your current map. So the big system right now is what's going on in the middle of the nation, actually, and it's just several pockets of stronger thunderstorms that happens to be the concern for this evening. Quiet along the eastern seaboard. As far as the amount of rain we're going to see, most areas looking at some light rain. Unless you're caught under a heavier thunderstorm, that could produce a heavier downpour. But these are still moving at a fairly good clip, again, northeast at about 35 miles an hour. Into the higher elevations of the north and west, this is where you might find maybe some significant snows, and some areas could pick up over 6 inches in the very highest mountain tops. Let's go into your forecast now, and I wanted to take you region by region for your Good Friday, showing you that some of the cool air is going to stick around in Boston, 37 during the morning, warming only about 10 degrees, we think, for the afternoon, mid-50s into New York City. Into the Finger Lakes region, stretching back into Pittsburgh, looking at some scattered showers. Going to find in Atlanta 55 degrees, and some areas may see some random showers popping up. Perhaps a better chance for seeing it might be into parts of Tennessee, stretching up into Kentucky and the Ohio River Valley, but can't completely outrule the chance for a thunderstorm popping up here. Finally, we work our way into the upper Midwest. Chicago starting out at 53. Now, that doesn't sound so bad, but you're going to have to deal with some rain on Friday, and you won't find much of a warm-up. 58 for the afternoon high, 67 with some thunderstorms around Cincinnati, and again on the backside of our low, some cooler air and a chance for some snow over much of the land of 10,000 lakes. It's going to feel a little more like winter than it will spring there. 38 into Seattle, 50 for the afternoon high with some rain, still an onshore flow coming into play across this region. Looking at Portland around 53, fairly decent, heading down into Southern California with some 60s expected there. Jeff standing by, he's going to give you the latest on your traveling weather when we return.
H&R Block works to get you every penny you have coming. And those pennies can really add up.
Someone to watch over me.
So then Doris is driving it, and she says, but Elliot, I can't feel the road. And I said, but what do you expect? It's a luxury car. Anyway, we then drive it down the road. Have you ever been
bored with traditional luxury? It could be time for the supercharged Bonneville, one of the world's most powerful sports sedans.
Do you drive a luxury car, Frank?
You bet your ascot I do.
Luxury with attitude. The Bonneville by Pontiac.
WeatherScope. It's all the weather you want. Every 30 minutes on the hour and half hour on the Weather Channel.
And now it's time for the Michelin Drivers Report, brought to you by Michelin and your participating Michelin dealers.
Well, we have some rain to talk about. Some rain has actually broken out in northwest Alabama, northeast Mississippi, ahead of our main area of showers and thunderstorms in eastern Kansas, northeast Oklahoma, now moving into Missouri and Arkansas. And we have some rain scattered about the northern plains as well, but it's this zone right here, right around northwest Arkansas and southwest Missouri, where there is the threat for severe weather, at least for the early part of the overnight hours. We're talking Springfield, Joplin, maybe even on up toward Columbia and Jefferson City, Missouri, just south of Kansas City. See this cell right here? This is a supercell. We've been tracking this one for the whole evening, and it has a history of large hail and some very gusty, even potentially damaging winds. Big batch of thunderstorms has rotated on up into Sedalia, but now a new batch has developed just east of Wichita near Andover. We'll watch that closely as it continues to pull to the east. Still could be some gusty winds there. Snow only in the higher elevations of the Pacific Northwest. If you're headed east out of Seattle on I-90, you could run into some slick roadways. We'll check all of that and where it's headed next.
At Michelin, we believe a tire that's just good in the rain isn't good enough. The Michelin X1, with a 6-year unlimited mileage tread life warranty, gives you better wet traction than any rain tire, plus Michelin confidence in most driving conditions. It has to, because the way we see it, you don't just cover a lot of miles, you cover a lot of weather. The Michelin X1.
Find Michelin tires at this dealer near you, because so much is riding on your tires.
Ahead on WeatherScope, Midwestern areas should still be on the lookout for rising flood waters. Stay tuned for updates coming up on WeatherScope after your local forecast.
This is your local forecast. Weather information you can plan on, only on the Weather Channel. WeatherScope.
It's been an active weather night across the center of the country tonight. We've seen severe thunderstorm warnings, one storm hanging together from southwest of Tulsa all the way up into northwestern Arkansas, southwestern Missouri. Hi, everyone. I'm Warren Madden. Thanks for joining us.
I'm Paul Emmick. We have had very, very stout storms to talk about. That's
stout.
Right, Warren. Yeah,
stout.
Very.
You've been saying that all night. What does stout mean, Paul?
I don't know. It means like built strong.
built
strong.
Built to last.
Right.
Okay.
Been dropping some hail, like a nickel to golf ball sized hail. Some places like an inch and three quarters diameter hail all around, like Kellyville, and to
there. We also have two severe thunderstorm warnings in effect in Arkansas. These are for Jackson County and Eastern White County until 12:35 a.m. Central Standard Time. And that's these storms right in here that have passed through the Little Rock area and have produced some hail of their own. We move up a little bit, and here you can see those storms a little better east of Wichita heading in toward the Missouri border. And this is the area that is under the watch right now, so I would not be surprised at all if we see some more severe thunderstorm warnings pop up. One of the biggest hailstorm stones that we've seen out of this fell in Tulsa, 4 3/4 inches long by 2 3/4 inches wide. That is one big chunk of ice to be dropping out of the sky, and we certainly hope no one was underneath it when it hit. Our look at the lightning data right now shows most of the lightning now concentrated actually in eastern Missouri and stretching down into Arkansas, but there you can see that line of storms we were pointing out in southeastern Kansas, and that is still moving to the northeast. So Kansas City, especially the southern suburbs of Kansas City, you might be hearing some rumbles of thunder before too long. Now we go to the current map, and really the big story about this is what is not causing these severe storms. Now we have the storm system here, but the storms are occurring well in front of the cold front, so it's certainly not occurring because of that. Is it occurring because of a big difference in temperatures? No. Look at this. 50s and 60s where the storms are occurring, the cold air hundreds of miles farther north and west, so it's not that big contrast in temperatures. Is it the dew points? Well, yes, we are getting some moisture coming up out of the Gulf of Mexico, so that's providing some of the fuel that those thunderstorms need. So the question remains to be answered, why are these thunderstorms popping up where they are popping up? Well, we're going to show you why. Yes, we are. And the answer lies in this spin right here. This is the water vapor loop. It's looking at the water vapor moving around in the atmosphere, especially at the upper levels of the atmosphere. And this is an upper level disturbance, an upper level low pressure system pulling across the center of the country. It's acting to pull air from close to the ground upward. That upward motion is helping to feed the thunderstorms, and that is why right in this general area, we are seeing severe thunderstorms this Thursday evening slash soon to be Friday morning right here in the center of the country. Now we put it all back in perspective for you. There's our severe weather. Now of course, this is only a portion of the United States, and we are trying to give you the full picture here. And let us point out a couple of other things that are happening. You go to the radar and here's our severe weather, but we do have a system moving into the northwest that we should talk about a little bit, and a little bit here going on in the northern plains. We start off with our precipitation forecast showing the heaviest amounts here in the Mississippi River Valley and also here in the northwest. And notice this little green streak here? That'll be falling in the form of snow. You could see 6 to 12 inches in the Cascades. Snow advisory in effect for the Cascades and over into eastern Washington. And that will extend also into the Blues and into the Cascades of Oregon. Okay. We go around the country now and show you the forecast for your Friday. 37 for your low in Boston. 48 in New York City. Should be fine along the coast for your good Friday, if you have the day off, perchance. But as you work your way into western PA and New York and down into the Ohio River Valley, watch out for showers and thunderstorms to be popping up. 66 for your low in New Orleans. 57 in Charleston. Hiding up to a high of 79 in Atlanta. But there are those thunderstorms coming into the Tennessee River Valley. Also a little bit here, stretching from the coast of Georgia back in toward Pensacola. We go to the Midwest, 53 is all you'll drop down in Chicago before you get too overjoyous. You're only heading up to a high of 58, so much cooler than you saw today. Rain around, thunderstorms as you head down toward Indianapolis and Cincinnati, and a little snow as you get into northern Minnesota. And across the west, 36 for your low in Salt Lake City, 48 in San Francisco. A fine day along much of the Pacific coast, except the Puget Sound area and Olympic Peninsula picking up a little rain, and windy in the northern Rockies. Coming up next is your traveler's update.
Oh, bathroom. Oh, bathroom.
Now it's time for the Michelin Drivers Report, brought to you by Michelin and your participating Michelin dealers.
A little rain around the edges, if you will, especially the Pacific Northwest. Some light rain, some higher elevation snows, though, in this region. Still some rain. Little flakes, too, of snow up here in parts of North Dakota. Mostly rain, though. Storminess moving on. Big-time storms, though, still firing in parts of Missouri, on into even some sections of back into Kansas. Still some stormy weather. Oklahoma and Arkansas, too, storms there. Expect some strong weather possible through this region on through noon, but expect the severe potential to be kind of sliding through parts of Kentucky, Tennessee, Mississippi, back into parts of Alabama and back. That's going to be kind of the focus later in the afternoon. All through this region could be quite stormy. Right now, a severe thunderstorm watch in effect in this region until 3 a.m. Could see the possibility of more severe storms. There's one of the stormiest of cells now off to the northeast of Wichita. Quite stormy. We will watch that throughout the evening. Rainy travel, some of that to contend with here through this region, some too into the Dakotas. Wintry travel, a couple of spots here, just a few flakes, North Dakota, northern parts of Minnesota as well. Windy, quite windy through here, and gusts around 50 miles an hour on the Guadalupe Pass. We'll give you a specific look at the Pacific next.
At Michelin, we believe a tire that's just good in the rain isn't good enough. The Michelin X1, with a 6-year, unlimited mileage tread life warranty, is the one tire that gives you better wet traction than any rain tire, plus Michelin control in most driving conditions. After all, it hasn't rained that much in years. The Michelin X1.
Find Michelin tires at this dealer near you, because so much is riding on your tires.
This is your local forecast. Weather information you can plan on, only on the Weather Channel.
Thanks so much for tuning us in here on the Weather Channel. I'm Jeff Morrow. I'll be with you for the next half hour. Let's go ahead and put a Pacific satellite picture into motion. And what we see is yet another system moving into the Pacific Northwest with more rain and some mountain snows. Snow levels down to about 2,000 to 2,500 feet. There we go. That's where you might find the snow from those elevations and higher. We have another system waiting in the wings offshore here, and we have an upper-level low that's been spinning down here southeast of Hawaii, which is kind of pulled away toward the northeast. Hawaii not looking too bad at the present time. Let's head back to the good old USA, and this is not a good time for this. There we go. Oh, brother. I hope the batteries in this are working all right. We have one low pulling out into the Central Plains. Believe it or not, this is the one that was bringing some inclement weather to the northwest last night. And, of course, we have the rain with our next system. It's a whole progression of these stacked out right into the Pacific Ocean. So, again, it's not going to stay dry very long, and it definitely isn't dry here in the Pacific Northwest. With more onshore flow continuing, Seattle getting some rain. Looks like we have that convergence zone thing going again north of Seattle with some locally heavy rain. And again, if you head up above 2,500 feet, you get into some snow. And there are some snow advisories out for the Washington Cascades. And some of that precipitation extends right down the Cascades all the way down to around the Medford vicinity. High temperatures on your Thursday. Got up to 82 in Vegas, 83 at the Sky Harbor Airport. But a cooler 67 in L.A. and 65 at San Diego. Seattle at 50 with your rain and 55 in Portland. All right, it is currently 43 in Seattle, 40 at Spokane, 46 in Lewiston. Stampede Pass has been snowing on and off, some of it kind of heavy over the last several hours at 29 degrees. It's 57 at Red Bluff, 54 at Sacramento, and 54 at Monterey, 62 at Fresno, and 43 at Tahoe Valley. Palm Springs coming in at 72, 57 at the LA Civic Center, and 54 at Santa Barbara. No earthquakes to report to you in Southern California, but right near Antioch, there have been several quakes up to about the upper threes on the Richter scale. So a little rumble there. That's not right along the San Andreas. That's a little bit north of there. So we'll watch that area to see if anything else develops. Nothing to report to you earthquake-wise in the Pacific Northwest, and really nothing here in Alaska, although we're still getting aftershocks of a fairly major quake out there toward Adak. Yesterday was over 6, was the highest reported. Still getting aftershocks up into the fours, upper fours. But again, that's off this particular map. As far as the rest of the nation, two systems here. Actually, there's one low to the north, a little bit of rain back toward Rapid City, a little snow up around Bismarck, believe it or not. Yesterday, we were in the 70s. And then we have another upper-level system pulling out of the southern and into the central plains. That has been spawning some pretty severe weather, and that's why there still is a severe thunderstorm watch for southwest Missouri, extreme northwest Arkansas, east Kansas, and eastern areas of the state of Oklahoma. But notice we had a supercell thunderstorm move east of Tulsa earlier. That has bit the dust as it moved up into Missouri. Now look at this line developing. A pretty nasty-looking line of thunderstorms has now rotated east of Wichita and Andover and is moving on over toward western Missouri. Kansas City about right here, so south of Kansas City, some pretty big storms. We'll have to watch these closely. They are capable of producing some very gusty winds and some hail as they move east over the overnight hours. All right, Pacific Regional Forecast time. Let's start off with your Friday morning weather map. Good Friday. One low continues to pull.
58 degrees heading into downtown Los Angeles and looking at some 70s and some 80s as we head on into other parts of Southern California. Northward we go. Of course, it's going to be a little bit cooler starting out the day around 48 into San Francisco, 45 in Sacramento. You should warm things up in these spots into the 60s and 70s. So not a bad looking day heading into the valleys around the American River. Not looking too bad. Lower 70s there. San Francisco around the Presidio looking at readings around 63. Could be a little bit warmer though. Up coast you'll find Ukiah at around 70. And finally we'll work our way into the north and west. Seattle at 38. Little rain again mixing in during the morning, and let's see if that will last into the afternoon. Probably so. As our high moves on in, it's actually moving in south of Seattle, so the onshore flow will come on in, spread some more clouds on in, and bring in a little bit of moisture. Showery weather here for you in Seattle, 50 degrees. Quileute, similar story. But you should see at least some sunshine heading on into Portland with, again, temperatures there into the lower 50s. And looking at some mid-50s, a little bit warmer around Pendleton heading east of the Cascades. But the rain that you have now will be letting up at least temporarily overnight on into early Friday. And we're going to be talking also about some snow letting up in the higher elevations as well. Let's go ahead and look at your forecast heading into the holiday weekend. And we're talking about some 30s into the northern plains and the upper Midwest. Lots of 30s across this area, so the cold air remains kind of entrenched in this region. And although you have a nice, toasty, warm Good Friday from the Great Lakes on into parts of the Northeast, by Saturday we start to see the next area of low pressure pushing on eastward, and it's dragging the cold air in from Canada in behind it, so cooling things down into the 40s for Easter Sunday, heading on into, say, Chicago and Milwaukee, Indianapolis, Toledo, Columbus, Cleveland, Cleveland could even see some 30s as you get some of that cool wind blowing in off the lakeshore. So some chilly air for Easter Sunday. The sunrise services will certainly be on the cool side, and it's not really going to warm up very much on into the afternoon. Different story in the southeast, though. Not looking bad here. You'll find some sunshine, and while it will be a little bit cooler than what we've had recently around Atlanta, we will at least find some spring-like 60s across that region. Again, some cooler air continuing into the northeast for your Monday. Looking at the rain here for Saturday, the showers coming to an end, being replaced by a few snow showers around the Great Lakes as the colder air moves in. Easter Sunday promising some more rain heading into Seattle, and certainly promising some more rain into the northeast. But much of the rest of the nation is looking fairly dry. A few scattered showers and thunderstorms heading maybe around the Houston, Galveston area, all the way back down toward Brownsville.
Every time your life changes, so do your taxes. Shouldn't you have someone who can help you pay less or get back more? H&R Block.
Someone to watch over me.
When Sam was hurting, he'd take Tylenol. But hours later, he'd have to take more. Then he discovered Aleve. He could take just two all day.
Tylenol was taking up to eight.
Aleve works up to 12 hours.
Aleve. All day strong, all day.
This is your local forecast, weather information you can plan on, because we show it on the 8s of every hour. Local on the 8s on the Weather Channel.
Many ways to achieve success. Of course, working hard is number one. Next is be careful how you spend your money. Spend it wisely. I've seen the rewards of this way of thinking. When I need an extra car, I still call Rent-A-Wreck. I drive quality cars. I just don't spend a lot of money. They'll even pick you up.
For real value in renting a car, truck, or van, call the Rent-A-Wreck location nearest you. Mention the Rent-A-Wreck family to receive your special bonus.
Now you can give them pizza whenever they want.
Pizza in the morning, pizza in the evening, pizza at supper time. When pizza's on a bagel, you can eat pizza anytime.
Pizza Bagel Bites. Bite-sized pizzas on wholesome little bagels.
Hey, America, Louisiana was wondering. Like to take a walk? Do it New Orleans style. Going out to eat? Drop by our place for dinner. Whether we're bass fishing at Toledo Bend State Park or enjoying gracious living in plantation country, we do things a little bit differently here in Louisiana. So come march to our drummer. For your free Louisiana tour guide, call 1-800-76-GUMBO. Louisiana, come as you are, lead different.
WeatherScope, it's all the weather you want. Every 30 minutes on the hour and half hour on the Weather Channel.
Well, it's time now to take a look at international weather and some good news here heading into Saturday. That is that high pressure is building into western portions of Europe, and that is supplying you with some sunshine. So if you're heading over into the British Isles, into anywhere in France, especially on into Paris or even into the Iberian Peninsula, you'll enjoy some sunshine and some warmth. That's where the warmer temperatures can be found. Much of March has been warm over much of Europe, and here we are into the end of March and seeing some true signs of things cooling down central on into eastern sections of Europe. Athens, a few showers and lower 60s there for Saturday. Mostly cloudy skies. Brussels on into London. Look for low 60s in Madrid with mostly sunny conditions and plenty of sunshine in Frankfurt. Upper 40s. So definitely pack the lightweight jacket. If you're heading anywhere in Eastern Europe, you will encounter some cooler air. Finally into Paris, partly sunny, temperatures around 50 near the Eiffel Tower. And look for mostly cloudy skies in Vienna, readings in the lower 40s. Finally, we're going to check on weather and your health when we return.
See ya.
See ya.
Night, Daddy.
I go out walking.
When it comes to building a comfortable home, you certainly have your options. But making your home feel as good as it looks requires an essential. Ask for Tyvek Home Wrap from DuPont. It helps keep weather out, comfort in. And that's basic to better building.
Tyvek House Wrap. Made by DuPont.
Weather. Every day it moves and changes. There's something happening somewhere, and we bring you all of it in WeatherScope, the day's top weather stories, with live on-the-scene reports during major breaking events, up-to-the-minute forecast for the nation and specific regions, and fascinating insight that lets you understand exactly what's happening and why. WeatherScope, it's all the weather you want. Every 30 minutes on the hour and half hour on the Weather Channel.
It's time now to check on weather and your health, and a quick peek at the influenza chart here showing only widespread outbreak into Arizona. Sporadic outbreaks into New York, Pennsylvania, Texas, Idaho, even Alaska and Hawaii. But as you can see, the flu bug is running its course now as we head into the spring months. And pain index will be a little bit higher when we find a drastic change in pressure. So we'll find that in the northwest, and also with our system now in the central plains moving eastward, we'll find that into the Great Lakes region. Where we find the cooler temperatures is where the respiratory distress will be a bit above normal. That would pretty well spell out the northern plains and the upper Midwest. That's where some of the cooler readings will be for your Good Friday. And in the northeast, chilly there too, but we think the respiratory distress will be about normal. No large-scale areas of air stagnation are expected on into Friday. Coming up next, we've got the full details on your spring weather. We've had some severe weather this evening. We'll tell you whether that is said and done and what you can expect for Friday.
This instrument explores your fragile gums,
a procedure for gingivitis.
Help avoid gingivitis.
Use Listerine. Only germ-killing Listerine is clinically proven to help prevent gingivitis. The power of prevention. Listerine.
You'd better hurry. No time to waste. It'll be over before you know it. During March Madness sale days at Carpet One, every color and style of DuPont Stainmaster carpet is on sale at dramatic reductions. But hurry. The time to save is now. You'll pay no interest for nearly 2 years when you buy DuPont Stainmaster at Carpet One before March 30th. No interest till 1999. Call 1-800-CARPET-1 and visit one of the 750 stores near you. Carpet One, where you always get more and always pay less. But time is running out. March Madness ends March 30th.
Or give me death!
Patrick Henry, you've just proclaimed give me liberty or give me death. Bet you're headed to Disney World.
No, I'm going to Williamsburg.
For your 97 vacation planner, call 1-800-HISTORY.
Right now, the weather is changing. What's here today can be gone tomorrow. Because we know you need to plan and prepare, we dedicate a special team to forecasting the outlook for the days ahead. So you know what to expect, watch our 5-day planner, 20 minutes after every hour on the Weather Channel. No place on Earth has better weather. Get detailed ski conditions for over 200 resorts on the Weather Channel website, www.weather.com. No place on Earth has better weather.
The psychic advisor is so convinced that psychics are the best, it's offering 10 minutes free just to prove it. Let's get the real story.
Ever called a psychic?
No.
Want to try?
Sure.
No gimmicks, 10 minutes free. That's your introductory offer to call the psychic advisor now.
How was it?
She knew I was going through a bad breakup, but said, no more tears. It's not my fault. Look out, girlfriend. Here comes trouble.
You go, girl.
Give me that phone.
Everything to gain, nothing to lose. Call now for your 10 minutes free.
Excuse me, would you like to try a psychic reading?
The psychic advisor wants you to get what you call for.